Hi, everybody. Rhys Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Every time Texas or Texas A&M play the fight song, they are reminded how much they dislike the other side. Texas fight song says so long to A&M. A&M's fight song says goodbye to Texas University. They'll say hello to each other in the Lone Star Showdown. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
Star Showdown. These two Big 12 rivals have been waiting all week to get on the field.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
This one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. He'll take it from the two. Across the 30. Tackle made at the 38-yard line.
Getting ready to take the field in their final home game in their career. The final games always have an extra emotional element in them. We'll see if they can channel that emotion and turn it into a victory.
The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He hits him hard at the 50-yard line.
The Longhorns have a player that's up for national awards. It's all speculation right now. You can talk about awards after you win them. He's got to worry about playing this football game.
From the 50, first down. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
He's taken down at the 34-yard line.
You know, I talked to so many college quarterbacks who have gone on to be very successful in the NFL, and they all talk about the execution of the play action. And all of them talk about the good ones, about taking their time and really working to sell the play action and sell the fake. If you don't take the time as a quarterback to really sell the fake, it's going to make it easy on the linebackers and safeties to realize that that was just a fake handoff and to get back in position. But when you really work it and sell it the way that quarterback did right there, that's when it's more effective. It can open up the big plays.
From the 30-yard line, it's second down. Down he goes at the 18-yard line. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
And he's taken down at the 10-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from. Runs outside for a nice game. Good run by the quarterback.
The thing that impresses me is the decision making. He sees it opening, decides to turn it upfield, and gets a nice gain and a first down.
This is the eighth play of this drive.
Brought down at the 6-yard line. Loss of one there for the halfback. We've got second and goal. Ball on the 6-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it third and goal.
This is the 10th play of this drive. He's in trouble. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
I like the call here. Well executed by the offense. You want to be sure you get 6 points when you're this close to the goal line.
He tacks on the extra point. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
Let's take a look at Lovett. It felt as if the game rested on every play. The Red Raiders prevail by a deuce.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. Campbell looks ready to kick this one off. Taken from the 3-yard line. And he's taken down at the 30-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. The stop around the 41-yard line. Makes it out to about the 49. Around the 49-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
He's on the run. Runs with it, and he's got room. He's tackled at the 39. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 22. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. 200. Quick pass. Tackle made at the 7. They come out in a 5-wide set.
Hammerhead. Throws to the receiver, incomplete.
Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. 7-0, Texas.
Back to the action now here in the second quarter.
And he's tackled at the 5-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it third and goal.
And a man open, touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. He makes the PAT.
So an 11-play, 69-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown game.
We're even at 7 in this one.
He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 26-yard line.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. He's to the 40, gets to around the 42.
First down.
From their own 42-yard line, it's first down. He's at midfield. They'll bring him down at the 47.
That's a nice job by the quarterback to pitch the ball, and it got him a first down.
Going deep, lays it out there,
and he's hit immediately.
That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. And he adds the extra point.
So a 4-play, 74-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
The score now, 14-7.
They line up to kick this one away. Anderson fields it at the 9. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with the big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Head protection, now scrambles. He's tackled in the open field. Throws it, and he's level at the 45.
Touchdown,
to that quickly. He's taken down at about the 43-yard line. He's scrambling. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
Gaining 4 yards. That'll make it second and seven. Larry,
Larry. Eat it out. Mike, 55. Right there.
Ready, check.
Red 18.
Box two.
Red
18.
He scrambled, looking for the corner. That's a great tackle at the 38. And he didn't get much on that scramble before they drilled him.
Right, that's a great way for the quarterback to get himself injured. He needs to be a lot more careful out there.
From the 38-yard line, it's third down. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury.
Ready, green on the line.
Deep ball, laying it out there. That close to being intercepted.
We've got a change at the quarterback position. Got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning.
So they're going to go for it here.
So the Aggies' quarterback taken off earlier, down on the sideline right now. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we'll see him back in the game before the day is over.
Looks middle, got his back. And down he goes, around the 30-yard line. Out of bounds at the 26. From the 26-yard line, second down. Zips it. And he's taken down at about the 21.
Just like a play-action pass relies on the defense respecting the run, a delay relies on the defense respecting the pass.
From the 16-yard line, first down, five wide. Steps up in the pocket. Zips it to his receiver, touchdown.
These poor guys in the secondary look like they're still trying to catch up with him. He's gone in a heartbeat.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he hits the PAT. It was an 11-play, 78-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. Burke has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. There's a strike complete. He's out to the 30. Brought down at the 34. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
From their own 34-yard line, first down.
Here we go. Kill. Panther 2.
stop in his tracks with that tackle. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Slings it. And they make the stop at the 40.
Hey, kill, kill, kill. Back five, back five.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Red seven, red seven. Watch the slant, watch the slant. Go.
That's going to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
That makes it fourth and four.
Robinson is back deep to return the punt. Brought down at the 33-yard line.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
Now he tries to buy some time. Sheds that one. Brought down in the open field.
They got a few yards there, but they need to be thinking bigger right now.
Texas A&M's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
It's second down, five to go. Ball on their own 38. They come out in an empty backfield. Now he's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. And he hits him hard at the 44. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle at the 32. Defense goes with the extra defensive back as the offense comes up five wide. He's tackled right around the 22-yard line. Texas A&M will take their last time out.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. He gets it up, and it's good. This return should be the last play of the half. He'll need to break it all the way to give his team the lead. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 23-yard line. We've got a great game here, folks, as we reach the end of the first half. 17-14, Texas A&M.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being, and we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game. Living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way if Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
Robinson's back to return.
He'll take it from the two. He's taken down at the 20-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Texas A&M holds a field goal lead. Up the middle for a nice game.
That's a game seven, my brother. That'll make it second and four.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
Anderson on the tackle with the 29-yard line. Here we go, third down.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He's to the 40. Tackle made at the 42-yard line. They come out in a five-wide set. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three.
Nice play here by the senior to make the sure tackle. It's not very often that someone's able to shake this guy.
Quick out to his receiver. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's at the 20. And they push him out right around the 12-yard line. From the 12-yard line, it's first down. Texas A&M is up a field goal. He tackles him hard at the 12.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Looks to a receiver. Touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He's tackled at the 19-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Complete. He's got room. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 28.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He goes downtown. The defender had it and then dropped it.
Hey, this guy's got to forget about the drop. Remember, he was in good position to make a play.
Runs it right. Nice pickup. From their own 32-yard line. First down.
Here we go. Go!
He's got an opening. He's to the 40. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46. Gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
And two,
quick strike to the receiver. He's taken down around the 42-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 42-yard line, first down. Makes it to the 34.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. 2-yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
Kirk, we got a player down, obviously in some pain. They'll line it up again on third down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's leveled at the 25.
First down.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Got an opening. Gains his way to the 16-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Very good tackle in space.
Stanley makes the tackle at the 10-yard line.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. 5 wide. Touchdown, Longhorns. Run by the halfback to find the end zone.
Good play call here by the offense coordinator. He realizes when you get down into the red zone and you have a halfback like this, just give him the ball and let him find his way into the end zone.
And he converts the extra point. So a 12-play, 82-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 24-21. Tackle made at the 27. The Longhorns have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team's put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
I'm sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field. There's a strike complete. He's down. Folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. 24-21, Aggie. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. They come out on an empty backfield. Slings it out there incomplete. Wow.
Brad, you talk about having a strong arm. Next time, though, he might want to work on the accuracy.
It's third down and 6 to go. Ball on the 32. Texas A&M is up by 3. Wow, a big stop there early in the fourth quarter. And the way this game has been played and how tight it's been, every defensive stop will be huge. Daniels, the return man.
Daniels fields it at the 26. Tackle at the 31.
Early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight football game, and the game could hinge on this possession.
He's on the run. And down he goes
at about the 47-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line.
Black five.
Brought down around the 48-yard line.
That's a deep run. That brings up second and 9.
Short over the middle. And he's taken down at about the 45.
Hicks makes the tackle at the 45-yard line. Third down.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. And he's going to be sacked.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
The stop at the 30-yard line.
Stanley makes the tackle at the 30-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a 5-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Fires out to his wideout. Tackle around the 22-yard line.
Pollard makes the tackle at the 22-yard line. That'll bring up second and 3.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. He fights forward to about the 19.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. First down.
From the 19-yard line. It's first down. Gains his way to the 10-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
It's the 9th play of the drive.
Ball's coming out quick.
Huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. The short yardage defense here. He's tackled around the 1-yard line.
That brings him second and goal.
This is the 11th play of this drive. Made just outside the goal line. Third and goal for the lead. He's in. Touchdown. And they take the lead.
Yeah.
Here's the call from the referee.
Delay of game, offense.
And he converts the extra point. Texas lines up for the kickoff. Robinson from the 8. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Texas A&M's ranking, that doesn't mean anything right now.
Now, they've not played up to their expectations at all, but they have the football here late in the game. They're very fortunate to still have a chance to maybe win it because they've not looked like themselves.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Now he's scrambling. He's taken down around the 43-yard line. He scrambled, but he didn't get much.
Brad, this defense reacts too quickly for a scramble like that to work. He needs to spread him out a little bit more to try to create more room to run.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He scrambles. And he's taken down around the 45-yard line. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brent, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Under a minute left. He's tackled right around the 36-yard line. Stops the clock with a spike. They'll spread the field with five wide.
Ready, wide 80. Cut.
Quick throw. Well, you can see the elation on the defensive coordinator's side of things, and why not? His defense just came up with one of the biggest stops of the game in a vital spot in this fourth quarter. Now he tries to buy some time. He's at the 30. Tackle at the 28-yard line. Five wide. Scrambling around. He knows how to run. And he's tackled at the 9. In the shotgun and 5 wideout. He's on the run, tries to get around the corner, and down he goes.
At about the 7-yard line.
Moore gains about 2 yards on the scramble. Texas A&M will take their final timeout. This is the 10th play of this drive.
Penalty markers down. They took too much time.
Trying to go up by three. They'll kick the extra point. And he hits the PAT. A great one to win, a really tough one to lose. 31-28, Aggies. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action in this one?
Texas A&M comes away with bragging rights this year, and I'm sure the fans and students will enjoy it just as much as the players. They were the better team today and added another great chapter to this rivalry.
Does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.